California massacre sparks gun debate again with a community torn over the path forward. Thousand Oaks, California. Justin Bowes survived the mass shooting at Borderline Bar and Grill here on Wednesday by hiding behind a stairwell and fleeing with his girlfriend Nicole through the kitchen and out the back door. Despite the horrors of yet another gun-related massacre during which a Marine veteran killed 11 people in the bar and a law enforcement officer who responded to the attack, and despite the fear and trauma the attack inflicted, Bowes said he's fairly certain there won't be a wave of anti-gun protests in this quiet Southern California community. California already has some of the nation's strictest gun control measures, and the ex-military members and police officers who line dance to country tunes at Borderline are more likely to wish they had been armed inside the bar, equipped to take out the shooter before he could do as much damage as he did. This crowd is conservative-leaning, Bowes said Thursday night outside of the shuttered dance hall as smoke from nearby wildfires filled the air. If anything, they'll be for more guns, and rise up that way. The students at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida, set a template for gun control activism after an attack on their school in February that left 17 people dead. At the other end of the spectrum, there are communities such as Sutherland Springs, Texas, where a church shooting a year ago that claimed more than 24 lives prompted community calls for increased gun ownership as a way to protect the innocent. Thousand Oaks, an affluent community of Mediterranean homes about 40 miles from Los Angeles, seems likely to fall somewhere in between. Some residents spoke openly of wanting the mass shooting to inspire gun control, others said they would prefer more arms in public as a safety measure, and others seemed resigned to the status quo in America with a massacre problem. The grieving family of Telemachus Orfanos, a country music fan who survived the mass shooting at a Las Vegas country music festival last year only to be gunned down Wednesday evening, garnered attention when they called for gun control rather than the usual thoughts and prayers. Even so, in an interview with the Washington Post, the young man's father injected a dose of pessimism. If mowing down 5-year-olds at Sandy Hook didn't make an impression, nothing will, Mark Orfanos said. The bottom line is the NRA owns most of the Republican Party, and probably some of the Democratic Party as well. Until that vice is broken, this is not going to end. Thousand Oaks began as a planned bedroom community for Los Angeles in the 1960s, and it has grown more diverse and more affluent since, with the median home price rising to $669,500, twice the national average. It also has shifted its politics, becoming more Democratic, though Republicans are still the largest number of registered voters, 36% to the Democrats' 34%, the rest with no party preference. The city's state and federal representatives are now Democrats, and in 2016, Hillary Clinton beat Donald Trump here by a margin of nearly 10 percentage points in the presidential election. Republicans here